好，各位家长、各位同学，大家早安哦。我们第一场讲座是由我们智胜教育带来的这个专题讲座 ，How to get an edge for college admission。那我们现在以热烈掌声欢迎我们的讲员，好不好？谢谢。
Hi everyone. If you don't mind moving to the front, if it's possible, don't be shy. I don't bite. So. You may not be able to see the screen, so that's why if you want to move closer to the front, I welcome that. Okay, great. Well, thank you so much for being here this morning. I am Anjali Nadig. I'm the Consultant Operations Manager at Think Tank Learning, and I'm really proud to be here today to talk to you a little bit about college admissions as well as summer planning and extracurricular activities. I also have a few slides about scholarships, and I would really like to find out from you really what you're interested in. So if I could have a show of hands, who would like me to spend the most time on college admissions? Raise your hand. Okay, who would like me to spend the most time on summer planning and extracurricular activities? Raise your hand. Okay, a lot of you guys. And finally, who would like for me to speak about scholarships? Raise your hand. Okay, we have a few people for every category. So, well, I'm going to get started. And first, I'd like to see how many of you see a school on this slide that you would like your son or daughter to attend. Raise your hand. So we have George Washington, Boston University, Fordham University, anyone? Okay. How about this slide? University of Michigan, Boston College, Georgia Tech, UC Davis. I know a lot of people are interested in UC Davis. Show of hands. Okay. A few more. And finally, who sees, oh, sorry, this is the second to last slide. Who sees schools on here that you would like your son or daughter to attend? Berkeley, Georgetown, USC, Carnegie Mellon, UCLA. Raise your hand. Okay, a lot more people. And last but not least, how about this slide? Tier one schools, Harvard, Princeton, Yale, Columbia, MIT, Stanford. Okay, so almost all of you on this slide. You know, I really wanted to just show you, sort of as an exercise, as the tier goes up, obviously you have more and more students, more and more parents who want their sons and daughters to attend these schools. And, you know, it's a very simple exercise, but as we all know, the number of applications to all these elite tier one schools just keeps increasing year after year after year. However, we also see that the admissions rates go down for all of these schools. So if you can see back in 2006, we have a few schools up here, Washington University, Princeton, Northwestern, Harvard, University of Chicago. I'd like to point out, University of Chicago in 2006 had almost a 38% to 40% chance of being admitted. And now we're at 2012, where we're about a little less than 15%. So as you can see, it just keeps getting harder to get into the tier one schools. And you may be wondering why that is. Well, there are a lot of different reasons, and I've spent about 6 years studying why this is the case. So I've been a college admissions counselor for the past 6 years. Two of those have been with Think Tank Learning, and I've been able to see, you know, really the huge change in landscape that the college admissions scene has been going through for the past 6 years. So I'd like to talk a little bit today about why that is and how you can make sure that your son or daughter is the most competitive they can be by the time they get to their senior year. So if I can have another show of hands, how many of you have kids who are in ninth grade or younger? Please raise your hands. Okay, so quite a few of you. How about 10th grade? Okay, this is the perfect time to be here if you have kids who are in 9th and 10th grade. How about junior year or 11th grade? Okay, so they're getting ready to apply this summer, so that's great that you're here. And finally, how about seniors? Any seniors, any 12th graders? Okay, we have one. The same person who's interested in scholarships, I might add. Okay, great. So I wanted to get a show of hands because I really wanted to see, you know, where I should concentrate my time. And I see that we have a lot of younger students, which is great. Again, this is the best time to start as early as possible. For those of you who have, you know, 6th, 7th, 8th graders, also, I would highly, highly encourage for them to start, you know, developing interests, to start exploring extracurricular activities, because really by the time they're in 9th and 10th grade, they have to focus a lot on getting the highest grades possible, getting a lot of extracurricular activity and leadership activities. So, you know, the younger they start, the better it is. So this is another graph. I love charts. I love graphs. I got my master's in public policy, and I had to learn SPSS and statistical analysis. So, you know, this is one of my favorite ways to show people, you know, how the admission statistics are changing. So we have here some UC admission statistics, and we can see that, you know, just a few years ago, the number of applications increased almost, you know, by 10,000 or 5,000 applications. So even the UCs, let alone the private schools, this year I believe UCLA had about 80,000 applications. It's not on this slide, but I just did some research, and that is the highest it has ever been. So did you have a question here in the front, sir? Yes, this chart does include international as well as freshmen. I'm sorry? Yes, total applications. This year we did see a slight decrease in the number of community college applicants, but the overall application rate has definitely gone up. So it's getting more difficult. So our number one tip, I've already said it, but it's to start now. Start as early as you can. Start your kids in activities. I'm sure you're getting them, you know, into those karate classes, into, you know, I have to mention the spelling bee next door. It is so cute. We have like 5- and 6-year-old students, you know, competing in the spelling bee, and I walked in this morning before I got up here, and you know, I saw this second grader practicing all these words in this huge Merriam-Webster dictionary with her dad, and you know, I can remember this. I remember what it was like. I was a spelling bee competitor myself when I was growing up, and you know, I think it's easy for us to sort of forget how anxious, how nervous, you know, how difficult it is to be a high school student these days. They have to deal with a lot more things than we had to deal with. I actually had parents who did not grow up here in the U.S. They grew up in India. And when I was in middle school, when I was in high school, when I immigrated here to this country, you know, I didn't really have anyone to turn to. My parents, while they were, you know, very, very smart, and they got their master's and MBAs. They didn't really know how to advise me when I was, you know, in high school and applying to colleges. So I think it's really important for your students to be able to find a mentor. A lot of times, you know, they may listen to someone else, maybe in college or maybe a little bit older, but they may not listen to you, mom and dad. So that was kind of how I was too. Now I realize that my parents were right about a lot of things, but I didn't realize it in high school. So I want to stress that as well. If you have, you know, friends with sons and daughters who have been through the college admissions process, you know, encourage your kids to email them, to keep in touch with them, because they really are the best resources. All of the consultants at Think Tank Learning, we are here for one reason, and that one reason is to help students succeed. And, you know, they tell us a lot of things that I know they would never tell their parents. So, you know, I really, really encourage you to make sure that you develop connections and really help your kids network, because that's the best way to learn about what not to do. So begin planning now. So you've seen, you know, the admissions rates are decreasing, application numbers are increasing. So what can you start doing? So I want to talk a little bit today about, you know, what do college admissions officers really look for in the college application? And it's pretty simple. They look for two things. One is an outstanding academic profile. So we have the academic profile here, and then second is the personal profile. So you might be wondering, okay, what makes up these two things? Again, academic, pretty self-explanatory. It's your GPA as well as your standardized tests. So any of those, you know, heavy quantitative factors on your application, that all goes in the academic profile. The personal profile, however, is, you know, it's a little bit more interesting. There are more quirks to it. It's definitely the part of your application that you have the most control over in junior and senior year. So, you know, your extracurricular activities, you've been developing them maybe from sixth grade, seventh grade, or maybe, you know, you just started to explore some activities in 11th grade. But the most important thing to know about extracurricular activities is that you have to be unique. So whatever you do, make sure you stand out. You know, if you're serving meals to the homeless, then that's great. But if you can get a group of 5, 10, 15 people from your school and start a group that is dedicated to community service and homeless outreach, that's even better. So, you know, be as unique as possible. Try to stand out in whatever you do. Okay, the personal statement. That's a really interesting one as well. And, you know, I really encourage a lot of my students to start the summer before their senior year. You know, oftentimes they're out doing their summer programs, they're volunteering, they're sleeping because they haven't slept, you know, during the year. But it's really best to start this personal statement as early as possible. It's not like another homework assignment where, you know, you take one night to finish an essay. You know, it really takes a lot of thought, and it really takes a lot of articulation. And, you know, oftentimes,